good morning students. Today we'll start continuity and differentiability chapter. In this chapter, first we'll explain about continuity. Consider the function f of x equal to, it is 1 if x is less than or equal to 0, 2 if x is greater than 0. First we draw the graph of the function. This is x axis, x dash o, x, and this is y axis, y o, y dash. Now see here, first x is less than or equal to 0. Equal to 0 means it is 0 left hand side. See here, it is y value is 1, so it is like this, it will come. Now if x is less than or equal to 0, this is the point is 0 comma 1. Next, x is greater than 0. X is greater than 0 means it is 2. So here, suppose here a y value is 2. It will be like this. It is f of x equal to 2. X is greater than or equal to 0. Now observe here, continuity. Continuity meaning is the graph is continuous required. Means here, without lifting the pen, if when you draw the graph, then we can say it is continuous. For example, if x is less than 0, we know that already we found that left hand limit. What is the left hand limit? Limit x tends to 0 minus f of x. LHL equal to limit x tends to 0 minus f of x. Less than 0, what is the value? It is 1. So that value is 1. RHL equal to limit x tends to 0 plus f of x. Greater than 0, it is 2. Now here, LHL is not equal to RHL. Then we can say f of x is not continuous. If both are equal, then we can say it is continuous. Once again, see here, we will consider the function f of x equal to 1 if x is less than or equal to 0, 2f if x is greater than 0. See here, x is less than or equal to 0. So here, this side, left side, 0, y value is 1. So 0 comma 1, this side it is there. It is f of x equal to 1. Next, if x is greater than 0, the value is 2. So here, greater than 0 means it will not take 0. That's why it is, I am make blank here. It is f of x equal to 2. Now, clearly, how we are saying it is continuous. Left hand limit, right hand limit, both are equal. Then we can say f of x is continuous at that point. Now, take second example. Consider f of x equal to 1 if x is not equal to 0, 2 if x equal to 0. First we will draw the graph of the function. Now see here. Here what is here? X is not equal to 0, it is f of x equal to 1. X equal to 0, f of x equal to 2. Now see here, x equal to 0, f of x value is 2. So this is the point. Here it is 0 comma 2. 0 comma 2. X is not equal to 0, then f of x equal to 1. So here, it will come like this. Here, it will not take this point. It is f of x equal to 1. Now, just observe here, the graph also, it is not continuous. Means, for example, we know that sin x graph. What is the sin x graph? It will be continuous is there. So, without lifting the pen, we can draw the graph of the sin x. Then we can say sin x is continuous function. Now, like this, this function graph we cannot draw. That's why it is not continuous. Then, mathematically, how it is, we are experiencing here. Now, you take left hand limit. LHL equal to left hand limit means 0 minus left hand side. See, 0 minus means it is 1 only. RHL equal to 0 plus. 0 plus means right hand side. It is also 1 only. But here f of 0 equal to at x equal to 0. It is 2. Now here LHL equal to RHL. And it is not equal to f of 0. In this case also we are saying it is not continuous function. Now in generally, suppose if A is a point in the domain, then if f of x is continuous at x equal to A, then limit extends to A, f of x equal to f of A. This is one definition. Another definition, if LHL equal to, LHL means here limit extends to A minus f of x equal to limit extends to A plus f of x equal to f of A, then we can say that it is continuous at x equal to A. A function is continuous at a fixed point if we can draw the graph of the function around that point without lifting the pen. See here, this is important here. Without lifting the pen from the plane of the paper, then we can say f of x is continuous. Now what is the definition? Continuity definition. Suppose f is a real function on a subset of the real numbers and let small a be a point in the domain of f, then f is continuous at A if limit extends to A f of x equal to f of A. See, limit extends to A f of x means left hand limit and right hand limit both are equal. That is the meaning. It is equal to f of A. Now, this is briefly, we can write like this. Limit extends to A minus f of x equal to limit extends to A plus f of x equal to f of A. That is LHL equal to RHL equal to f of A. So, this is the definition of continuity. Now, we will discuss some point. First point, the constant function f of x equal to k is continuous. So, what is the given function? Given that f of x equal to k, let small a be any real number . Now take limit extends to a f of x. It is equal to limit extends to A. See, what is the f of x value? It is k. There is no x to substitute x equal to A. So, it is k. Now, f of A value also, it is k. Therefore, limit extends to A, f of x equal to f of A. Therefore, f of x equal to k is a continuous function. So, this is the proof of f of x equal to k is continuous. Already you know that constant function graph. Already you learned in first year. How it is there? Some constant. So, this is the graph of the constant function. We will learn here f of x equal to c in first year. It is f of x equal to k. Now, any breaks are there? There is no break. From graph also we can say f of x is continuous. Second point. The identity function f of x equal to x is continuous. Now, given that f of x equal to x, let small a be any real number. Now take limit extends to f of x. It is limit extends to a. F of x value is x. It is equal to a. F of a equal to a. Therefore, limit extends to a. f of x equal to f of a. Therefore, f of x equal to x is continuous. From the graph also, we can say f of x is continuous. See here, how is the f of x equal to x graph? It is like this. It is passing through the origin. So this is the graph of f of x equal to x. See here, in this graph also, we don't have any breaks. Then from the graph also, we can say f of x is continuous. Next, third point. The modular function f of x equal to mod x is continuous at x equal to 0. Now see here, given that f of x equal to mod x, we can add f of x equal to, what is the modular function definition? If x is greater than 0, then f of x equal to x. If x is less than 0, f of x equal to minus x. So it is x, if x is greater than or equal to 0, minus x, if x less than 0. Now take left hand limit, LHL equal to limit x tends to 0 minus f of x. It is equal to limit x tends to 0 minus less than 0. What is the function? It is minus x. It is equal to minus 0. It is equal to 0. Next, right hand limit, RHL equal to limit x tends to 0 plus f of x. It is equal to limit x tends to 0 plus, if greater than 0, f of x value is x. It is equal to 0. Next, f of 0 equal to, it is 0. Now, LHL equal to, RHL equal to, f of 0. Therefore, f of x equal to, mod x is continuous at x equal to 0. Now, f of x equal to mod x is continuous. From the graph also, we can explain it in continuous. See here, how is the f of x equal to mod x graph? It will come like this. Now, any breaks are there in that graph? There is no breaks. So, we can say from the graph, f of x is continuous at x equal to 0. Next, fourth point. The modular function f of x equal to mod x is continuous. Previous third point we will discuss at x equal to 0 only. Now, fourth one, it is continuous everywhere. Now, what is the modular function f of x equal to mod x? X if x is greater than or equal to 0, minus x if x is less than 0. We discuss at x equal to 0 only. X greater than 0 means at 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, like this all numbers will come, positive numbers. Less than 0 means negative values, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, like this every point negative values are coming. So here, first we will take if a is greater than 0, then means it is positive real number, then f of x equal to x. So it is f of a equal to, it is a. Limit x tends to a, f of x equal to, limit x tends to a, x. It is equal to a, equal to f of a. Therefore, f of x is continuous for a greater than 0. Similarly, we can prove for if a less than u. If a less than 0, then f of x equal to minus x. So here f of a equal to minus a. Now take limit x tends to a, f of x equal to limit x tends to a minus x. It is equal to minus a, f of a. Therefore, f of x is continuous for a is less than 0. See here, if x equal to 0 also, continuous already we proved in third point. Now see here, if greater than 0, continuous, less than 0, continuous, equal to 0, continuous. Then we can say f of x equal to mod x is continuous for every real number. Next, fifth point. Every polynomial function is continuous. So, let the polynomial function f of x equal to a0 plus a1x plus a2x square plus so on plus an x power n. This is the polynomial function. Now take limit x tends to a f of x. It is equal to limit x tends to a0 plus a1x plus a2x square plus so on plus an x power n. Substitute x value with a. It is a0 plus a1 into a plus a2 into a square plus so on plus an into a power n. It is equal to f of a. Then we can say f of x is continuous for all x belongs to R. So that meaning is every polynomial function is continuous. Means x, x square plus 1, x cube plus 3, x power 4 or x power n. Like this, every polynomial function is continuous. Next, sixth point. Suppose f and g be two real function continuous at a real number c. Then f plus g is continuous function at x equal to c. F minus g is continuous at x equal to c. F into g is continuous at x equal to c. F by g is continuous at x equal to c. Here, g of x is not equal to 0. So here means addition, subtraction, multiplication, divisible. If f and g are continuous, then these four functions also continuous. Means f plus g, f minus g, f into g, f by g. These are the continuous functions. If you want, take first one, limit x tends to c, f of x plus g of x. It is equal to limit x tends to c, f of x plus limit x tends to c, g of x. It is equal to f of c plus g of c. So we can say f of x plus g of x is continuous at x equal to c. Similarly, we can prove f minus g, f into g and f by g also continuous at x equal to c. Seventh point, every rational function is continuous. Now define f of x equal to p of x by q of x, where p and q are polynomial functions. Now see here, from previous property, p of x and q of x are continuous here. Because here, p and q are polynomial function. Every polynomial function is continuous. Next, the divisible of p of x by q of x is also continuous function. Then we can say f of x is continuous function. That meaning is every rational function is continuous. Next, last point, 8. Suppose f and g are real valued functions such that f circle g is defined at c. If g is continuous at c and f is continuous at g of c, then f circle g is continuous at c. This meaning is composite function is continuous at x equal to c. Here, what is the composite function? F circle g of x. It is f of g of x. This is the composite function. So here, f and g are continuous function. Then the composite of two continuous functions is continuous. So this is the 8th point. Now what we will learn, once again we will see here. First, we will discuss f of x equal to k. Every constant function is continuous. Next, identity function is continuous. And modular function is continuous at x equal to 0 and at every way. Next, every polynomial function is continuous. Every rational function is continuous. The composite of two continuous functions is continuous. Now we will go to the exercise 5.1. Question number 1. Check the continuity of the function f given by f of x equal to 2x plus 3 at x equal to 1. Now take limit x tends to 1 f of x. It is equal to limit x tends to 1 f of x value is 2x plus 3. Substitute x equal to 1. It is 2 into 1 plus 3. It is equal to 2 plus 3. It is equal to 5. F of 1 equal to 2 into 1 plus 3. It is 2 plus 3, 5. Therefore, limit x tends to 1, f of x equal to f of 1, f of x is continuous at x equal to 1. Second problem. Examine whether the function f given by f of x equal to x square is continuous at x equal to 0. Given that f of x equal to x square. Now take limit x tends to 0 f of x. It is equal to limit x tends to 0 f of x value with x square. It is equal to 0 square equal to 0. F of 0 equal to, it is 0 square, it is equal to 0. So it is limit x tends to 0, f of x equal to f of 0. Therefore, f of x is continuous at x equal to 0. Question number 3. Show that the function f given by f of x equal to x cube plus 3 if x is not equal to 0, 1 if x equal to 0 is not continuous at x equal to 0. So given that f of x equal to x cube plus 3 if x is not equal to 0, 1 if x equal to 0. Now take limit x tends to 0 f of x. It is equal to limit x tends to 0. See here, x tends to 0 means x approaches to 0. Either left hand side or right hand side. So that meaning is x is not equal to 0 only. What is the value here? X cube plus 3. It is equal to 0 cube plus 3. It is equal to 3. F of 0 equal to, at x equal to 0, what is the value f of x? It is 1. Therefore, limit x tends to 0 f of x is not equal to f of 0. Therefore, f of x is not continuous. X equal to 0. Question number 4. Prove that the function f of x equal to 5x minus 3 is continuous at x equal to 0, at x equal to minus 3, and at x equal to 5. Given that f of x equal to 5x minus 3. The observe here, f of x is a polynomial function f of x is a polynomial function. See, what is about polynomial function? Every polynomial function is continuous everywhere. Therefore, f of x is continuous for all x belongs to R. Now, particularly, f of x is continuous at x equal to 0 and f of x is continuous at x equal to minus 3, f of x is continuous at x equal to 5. Therefore, f of x is continuous at x equal to 0, comma at x equal to minus 3 and at x equal to 5. We can write like this also. So, using polynomial function continuous. See, 5x minus 3 is a polynomial function. Every polynomial function is continuous everywhere. Particularly, f of x is continuous at x equal to 0. That is the first bit. Second bit, f of x is continuous at x equal to minus 3. Second bit is over. Next, third bit, f of x is continuous at x equal to 5. Using definition also we are solving. We can write like this also. So, you can learn like this only. This is the easy method. Every problem, maximum problem, we are using this only. Polynomial function. Every polynomial function is continuous. Then, particularly, f of x is continuous. What are the given points saved there? That point it is continuous. Okay. Question number 5. Examine the continuity of the function f of x equal to 2x squared minus 1 and x equal to 3. Given that f of x equal to 2x squared minus 1. See here, 2x squared minus 1 is a polynomial function. So, every polynomial function is continuous everywhere. So, particularly, f of x is continuous at x equal to 3. So, this is the fifth question. Question number 6. Prove that the function f of x equal to x power n is continuous at x equal to n, where n is a positive integer. See here, f of x equal to x power n, it is a polynomial function. So, f of x is continuous for all x belongs to R. Therefore, f of x is continuous at x equal to n. This is the theory type. Now, otherwise, you can solve like this also. Or, general method also can solve. Limit x tends to n, f of x equal to, limit x tends to n, it is x power n, it is equal to n power n. Now, f of n equal to n power n. So, it is limit x tends to n, f of x equal to f of n. Now, we can say f of x is continuous at x equal to n. Any method you can follow, no problem. Number 7. Discuss the continuity of the function f given by f of x equal to x cube plus x square minus 1. Now, see here. Given that f of x equal to x cube plus x square minus 1. Here, this is a polynomial function. Every polynomial function is continuous for all x belongs to R. So, f of x is continuous. This is the method. Otherwise, you can solve in another method also. Let small a be any real number. Limit x tends to a, f of x equal to, limit x tends to a, what is f of x value? X cube plus x square minus 1. it is equal to a cube plus a square minus 1. F of a equal to a cube plus a square minus 1. Therefore, limit extends to a, f of x equal to f of a. Therefore, f of x is a continuous function, every real number. This is the alternate method. You can follow any one method. No need to have solving in two method in exam. Just you follow any one method. It is very simple. Polynomial function is continuous. Every polynomial function is continuous. What are the given particular point? You can write. It is continuous at x equal to 2 or 3 like that. Okay. Thank you for all. We continue in next class.